Thank you, Dave. Forgive me, I don't think I've got the microphone and I saw people here. Then I got back there and found that they were beggars, and so I'm doubly late. The rosary was a prayer that was of great importance to Jeanne. The family very often prayed it together when they were in the car. And so they requested that before the funeral mass today, we offer 5 decades of the rosary. We'll pray the glorious mysteries second glorious mystery is the ascension of our Lord into heaven. As Jesus prepared to ascend, he said to his disciples, "The eye has not seen, ear has not heard, mind has not conceived, of the kind of reward God has prepared for those who love him." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Thank you. interesting. The family tells me that so often when they were traveling in long trips in the car and otherwise around home, Jeanne would gather the children together and encourage them to pray this prayer. And I think it's worth a few minutes of time we can devote to it now to consider why. Why did she do that? That's kind of curious behavior, isn't it? To ask my children to pick her beads with me. But what was the purpose of it? What power did she ascertain in this prayer? What patience would what parents bring to her life? What reality did she communicate with through this? These are questions worth contemplating. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Eternal rest grant unto Jeanne, O Lord. Hail, Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. Lead me to cry, our banished children of Eve, to thee who sat on our sides, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn thy most gracious head and the eyes of mercy toward us. After this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God.
Evans Tour Detroit. Barber the Carver. Bless your pain aching heart. The good Lord. I love you. These are the few of the many phrases I remember Mom saying. Mom was born October 29, 1929. This was Black Monday, the day the stock market collapsed, where families' fortunes were lost, and the start of the Great Depression. It must have been God's way of saying, the earth is going to need Jeanne Blanck. Her life was spanned 11 decades. Mom had peacefulness within her. He smiled and made you feel welcome. It was easy for family, for strangers, to feel comfortable with Mom. She was love. That was her personality, her entire life. The last few years, as my mom was in and out of the hospitals, it was not unusual for nurses to comment what a good person she was. In a gathering, I would not consider Mom the life of the party, but more the heart of the soul. She grew up on a farm on the outskirts of Boonville, Missouri. Mom was a farm mom. She liked being outside, fishing, and growing her tomatoes on her balcony. She told stories of riding her horse, Topsy, to school. Growing up, we had many trips to Boonville. Mom's three brothers and her sister all had farms. There were many visits to the farm, providing great memories as a child. It was not unusual to milk a cow, play in the hay barn, or go mushroom hunting in the spring. Mom loved mushrooms. Mom liked all kinds of unique foods. Let's call them farm foods. It was not unusual to find a pot simmering on the stove. Could be turnips, parsnips, or even neck bones and sauerkraut. And Mom loved her neck bones and sauerkraut. I remember as a child looking under the lid after smelling something, smelling especially good, and seeing a big old cow tongue sticking out there. And I asked her, you know, how do you eat a cow tongue? And she said, well, you slice it, of course. Put it in between bread, maybe add some radishes. Mom loved her radishes. We also would be introduced to pickled pig's feet, head cheese, brown swiper. Mom was a farmer. Mom told me about the first family supper that she and her sister Mickey prepared. Her mother, Gammy, had gone into town, and Mom loved her mother. But she and Mickey were in charge of making a new meal for her dad and brothers who were working in the field. They thought they had made the best lunch ever. It consisted of a big bowl of watermelon and a big bowl of popcorn. Mom loved her popcorn. I think the girls were given a little word correction after that, as I don't ever recall that being a meal in our house. But growing up, we had family dinner every night. The kids would take turns setting the table and doing the cleanup afterward. I'm not sure if I ever appreciated the work and planning that went into family dinner every night. Thank you, Mom. As we got older, kids moved out of the house, but never very Sunday dinners began every Sunday at 6, and we'd come home for dinner. I'm not certain when the tradition started, but I do remember my first Sunday dinner. It was in the fall of 78. I had moved out right after high school. I was living in Northeast KC. Mark Jr. was on the way, and I was starting my own family. It had been several months since I had been by the house, and Dad called and invited Lucy and I to come to dinner the following Sunday. For the next 30 plus years, that turned into every Sunday. As the family grew, so did Sunday dinners. It was not unusual to have guests. Every Sunday, you would have to figure who was coming, decide how many leaves to put into the table. Whoever got there first would set the table. So that always led to strategic rival times. I'm not sure I always appreciated Sunday dinners. Thank you, Mom. Mom was a fan of many things. She loved music. She was playing the organ at St. Martin's Church by second grade. She went on to play the organ for hundreds, if not thousands, of weddings, funerals, and masses over the next 60 years. Mom was also a fan of Italian soloist Offutt and found peace listening to his music. Long before her death, Mom had entrusted Jennifer with her favorite soloist and songs she wanted for her funeral. Those hand-selected soloists are singing the hymns she requested here today. Thank you. Mom also was a fan of games. She loved playing bridge and all card games. Mom loved playing bridge. She especially enjoyed playing board games with her grandchildren on the holidays, whenever time allowed. Winning was not the most important thing to her. She loved the camaraderie. Enjoy being together. Mom was a football fan, and she loved the Chiefs. Mom and Dad, season ticket holders, from when the Chiefs first came to Kansas City in the 60s. Chiefs games were about the only thing that might alter the Sunday dinner time. Her favorite player, Otis Taylor. Patrick Mahomes was gaining ground. Mom liked to find out about the team next and who would lead the pregame prayer. If the Chiefs did lose, sometimes that is where the blame fell. Mom loved the Chiefs. Mom loved her faith, and she was good at it. Mom truly enjoyed the Mass. It brought her inner peace. She enjoyed saying the rosary, not just in times of need, but also in times of peace, kind of a thinking. In fact, it was her faith that brought her parents together. When Dad returned from the Air Force, Mom was just finished up high school. Dad had been good friends with Mom's older brother Esther and knew of Jeannie. Now that he was home, Mom was older, Dad was hoping to socialize with her. But Mom had a very active social life, and her dance card was always full. But Dad noticed Mom often attended the daily Mass, so Dad then became frequent for the next 70 years. Their marriage produced 7 children, and about 16 grandchildren. And 9 great-grandchildren. The challenges that came along with raising children, it says 10. So, 10 great-grandchildren. The challenges that came along with raising children never kept them from being loyal to their faith. My parents were very committed to keeping the Sabbath day holy. When traveling, one of the first questions asked to check in was, what is the local mass schedule? It seemed no matter what country, city, or state, there was always a Catholic church nearby. Mom prayed for us children, some of us more than others. Like a good shepherd, she prayed for whoever she thought needed it the most. I'm afraid my mom burned through a lot of rosaries on me. But I believe her prayers brought Mark Jr. and I together, Tina and Julie. I believe her prayers brought Mark Jr. and Natalie together. And let's face it, Mark Jr. and I, we both needed extra prayers. In fact, I believe Mom's prayers were answered when all of her children formed loving families of their own. Mom's not gone. She will live on forever with us, with our children, with our grandchildren, in our hearts. Mom loved her faith. Mom loved her family. Thank you, Mom. The best part was taking off the mask.
Blood related, but that never happened. I consider Nani just as much of a grandma to me as my biological ones. I never called her my step-grandma, and she never called me her step-grandchild. And even though Nani had her fair number of grandchildren, she still somehow managed to have a unique relationship with each of us. She wanted to know about my day and specific things that happened, and she could recall things that I told her years ago, and it just made me feel really special. But Nani was a special person. She welcomed anyone who came into her house, whether that was a friend coming for one family dinner, or a friend who never leaves, like Brandon. But the more the merrier was definitely her motto, and I think that's what makes being part of the Blanck family so much fun. Nani was certainly the matriarch of this family, and it won't be the same without her. But she made sure that we all understood how important her family is, and because of that is why I know we will remain close, which is exactly what she would want. So thank you, Nani, for always letting me know that I was loved and for bringing a smile to my face every time I saw you. You will be greatly missed. I love you.
I'd like to start off by formally reintroducing myself as Nani's favorite grandchild. She never said these words specifically, but she didn't have to because I knew it was true all along. Nani was the kind of woman that I thought to be ordinary when I was growing up. I had no idea how special I was to have her as my grandmother. I thought everyone's grandma was generous, kind-hearted, prayed the rosary like no other, and always had a smile on her face. She even had a smile on her face after I called her a liar when I was 4 years old, after she told me her name wasn't actually Nani. It wasn't until I got older that I realized, not everyone is obsessed with their grandparents. How strange. I had no idea that some people's grandmothers weren't one of their best role models. Her family was inarguably the most important and her favorite topic of conversation, board game teammates and opponents, and people to spend hours talking and being present in the moment with. Even during these uncertain times, all the Blanks made it a point to have Zoom calls on Easter, garage happy hours, and Nani's personal favorite, drive-by parades outside of her Kingswood villa. Nani loved getting to see all of us with our decorated cars, kids' heads sticking out the windows, and the screams and honking that would ensue as we drove our caravan up and down the cul-de-sac. Just a short week ago, as Nani was making her final trip home, she told Patty that she would love to have another parade when she got home and could be able to come outside to the garage to see all of us. I think Nani would be pretty impressed with She would be impressed with the parade to come today because we really pulled out all the stops with a police escort. Nani had so much love and joy for and with her family and us with her. One of the many things I loved about Nani was that she could always make me laugh no matter what. I went to see her a few weeks ago at St. Luke's Rehab, and I was beyond excited to see her. When I walked into the room, I saw a person sitting there, covered in blankets and tall socks. with big black sunglasses on. It took me a few seconds to confirm that this person was not me, but I was quickly able to reason that no other person would be cold on a hot July day like Nani. About 20 minutes into our visit, she touched her head and realized she still had her sunglasses on. She laughed about her forgetfulness and said that I must have thought she was a movie star when I walked in the room. She could always make me feel like I was the most important thing going on in her life, even when she was in the hospital and the obvious most important thing was her getting better. Her love was beyond tangible. One of my favorite examples of Nani showing her love in the smallest ways would happen in this church. When I was lucky enough to sit next to her at 7:30 Mass, after we prayed the Our Father, she would hold my hand for a few seconds longer once the prayer was over, and she would squeeze my hand. That small gesture, I think, was her way of saying, "I'm letting go of your hand because I'm supposed to, not because I want to." That was always my favorite part of my Sundays. My other favorite part of the day would be at the after-mass breakfast when she would confirm that I was better for Patrick Mahomes than his current girlfriend, Brittany. She was one of the most supportive people I've ever known, and she was an amazing person to call one of my best friends. I'll miss her endlessly, but I know she's having a blast in heaven and continues to be her family's fiercest protector.
In the waters of baptism,
eternal glory. God Almighty Father, our faith confesses that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Jeanne, who's fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. Those who trust in him shall understand truth. And the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
The response to our psalm is, "Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life."
I'm reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Her heart, for there were other would-be suitors. to win the affections of Miss Oswald. To his everlasting credit and gratitude, Bill noticed what his competitors did not. He saw that Jean was conspicuously religious in a Catholic kind of way, and so he devised a strategy nearly guaranteed to boost him to the top of the suitor class. Bill began to go to church with Jean, and as I understand it, there was a lot of church to go to. But Bill went, and Jean noticed and was even impressed by the tenacious, loving labors of this man. If he wants me so desperately that he'll even follow me to church, then maybe he will follow me in life, and I will follow him. And so 69 years ago, they married, and they birthed six boys and one girl. They became a pillar in this community of longstanding and high regard. And I'm sure there are a number of good reasons that the Blanck family enjoys to this day: a large number of friends and is roundly esteemed. Reasons having to do with dependability and professional competence and integrity and thoroughgoing modesty. But it is surely not too much to say that the mainspring of so much of it is this woman whose body now reposes in that casket. Jean was one of those women, those precious women, that we could properly call a matriarch. All her days, she gave life. And then having given it, she held it tight and protected it and cherished it and celebrated it. You have heard how nothing mattered to her more than being with her own, and how for decades she cooked a Sunday dinner and everybody came back to the roost to share food, to share life lessons, to share stories, and to learn the rhythms of piety and soul that made the Blanks a family and not merely a segregation of generations that shared a common surname. Why was Jean Blanck this way? She lived and died so well. Because when God hides from those who depend on their own wits and wisdom, he reveals to those who become humbly childlike before him. Indeed, as our reading from wisdom says, those who manage to trust in God understand truth, and the faithful abide with the Lord in love, because grace and mercy with his holy ones and his care is with his elect. Isn't this an apt description of the farm girl that turned the boys' heads, but would only give her heart to the young man who endorsed and imitated her walk with God? Fittingly, Jean died like she lived, that is to say, very well. Last Saturday, morning, in bed, She gently went home to the Lord she knew and who had guided her throughout the 90 years she lived among us. Maybe God gave her to us for so long because we have needed her kind so much. And you know, we still need her kind so much. Jeanne at length lovingly labored, and now God has given her rest. She had taken Christ's yoke upon her shoulders and learned the best lessons life afforded her from the humble and meek Jesus. Though she lives now in a new way, let us not forget her old ways. For from them are built the very road toward mortal wisdom and immortal serenity. Thanks for your attention.
Who at baptism was given the promise of eternal life, for a welcome of love and compassion among the communion of saints, we pray.
Hospitals and in hospice, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
confidence in God's promise to wipe away every tear. We remember all who have gone before us in faith, especially the family and friends of all gathered here. We pray.
Lord God, we give thanks to you for the life of Jeanne. She trusted that your words to her would be fulfilled. She was full of grace, and so her life was copiously fruitful. We acknowledge the wisdom and wonder of her works, and in these prayers, pray for the grace to imitate them all. We ask these things through Christ. Amen. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Jeanne, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was born, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church. And recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession, in your presence, we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, our Holy Father Francis, our Bishop James, all who minister in your church, and the entire people you have gained for your home. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you've gathered together this morning in sadness and in faith. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Jeanne, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth we raise up in the flesh those who died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, to all who are pleasing to you, the passing of this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, my God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow all the world, all. God Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Please stand. by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us all pray each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
The communion procession will come forward by way of one single file line in the aisle. When you are coming forward, wear a mask and maintain 6 foot distancing. The left section of the aisle will come first. You may have come forward. The right section of the aisle will come up. For health reasons, we ask that people receive on the hand, step aside, remove your mask, and then consume the most. Then put the mask back on. Please keep your hand flat when receiving the Eucharist to avoid contact with the minister.
Thank you.
One day.